Hello, teacher. My name is Bunshinita Banton.
My name is พีรพลพานุวัฒน์สุข
My name is เพชรสุดาพรบำรุง
Okay, today we will represent logging A for dealing hole. This pipe is used to deal component with parallel hole in the desired location. We will rotate the arm out and insert the component into the component bed lock and adjust it to the desired position. Then rotate the arm back to the component position and rotate to be able to attach the component. After that, we can put it in the drilling machine and we will get the workpiece with hole as we want. The next, we will talk about the detail of this piece. We will use a T-wheel and first angle projection image and section and about datum to explain to you know about it. Next two.
For a pipe, for the base. For the base, 40 millimeter wide, 49 millimeter length, 10 millimeter thick. Top view, there will be a hole of 8 times 4 millimeter for connecting to the wall and component lock base. The front view has a hole of 2 times 4 millimeter. For connecting to the butch wall, base is used for fixing wall, butch wall, and component lock base, not to move when during the workpiece. For butch wall, butch wall 40 millimeter wide, 52 millimeter length. With a radius of 20 and 10 millimeter thing and a cutting section to know the size of the hole for inserting the bush and socket screw. A bush wall is used for a hole to put the bush according to the size of the hole that we want. For component lock base. Component lock base 17 millimeter wide, 40 millimeter length, 15 millimeter thick, and angularity 0.05 at the datum A and has a cutting section so that the hole for the nut and pin. A component lock base is used for testing component to drill hole for the wall. Wall is 40 millimeter wide, 50 millimeter length, and 16 millimeter thing and has a cutting section to see the size of the hole for both the top and bottom nuts. The bottom hole is 8 and 6 deep. The top hole has a circumference of 6 and 9 deep. A wall is used to put the arm nut and hold the component to the design depth.
Next is a bush. The bush is have two part. Overall length is 13 millimeter. There are two part. The top one is 13 also in 13 in diameter. The top part is this part, the wider part, is usually in the outside of the bush wall. and the second part is smaller one had 10 millimeter diameter and all the way have hole that have 5 millimeter diameter the same as component hole. The bush is very useful part because the bush can guide the drill, so you can use it and drill the component precisely. And bush have to they have to because the component have to have two hole. The next one is pin. This pin is short one. The diameter of the pin is 4 millimeter and length is 13. This short pin used to inside the one of the base lock with the wall, so it can move it while we screw with the socket screw. The next one is another pin. This pin is longer than previous pin because have to stay with the base lock, so it have to be longer, and it's 15 millimeter in length and also 4 in diameter. The next one is arm is very complicated. One of the most complicated thing move part of this machine. It have a length of 22.25 millimeter, and one end have a half circle or semicircle that have 9.5 in radius. Another end has 8.25 in radius, and there are two holes. One hole is a bore hole, and another one is small bore hole, and another one is screw hole. So the smooth bore hole is usually locked by the next part, and it can move freely. The diameter of the smooth bore hole is 7 millimeter in diameter, and the another one is screw hole. So this part can be screwed up with also another part in the next part. This have screw because in the next part also have a screw surface, so you can move it and tighten the component to make it not loose easily. And the hole of this is 9.5 in diameter, and the screw scale is M0.7. The next one is basket pin. This part used to come with the previous part because then there are three sections. You can see the smooth section in the middle. It used to stay and make it the part one can move. So begin with the first part of this part. The first part is the top part that 9.5 in diameter, and thickness is in 4 millimeter. That separate two parts that by 2 millimeter gap, because we can screw up with flathead screwdriver to make it tighten with arm and the wall. The second part is the smooth one. This one smooth ball armhole. Smooth ball armhole. The diameter used to be the same as the armhole that I mentioned previous. It's 8 millimeter in diameter, and the length the high part is 9.5. This one have to be very smooth, because if it's not smooth, the arm cannot rotate freely and it will stuck. The third part is the screw one. This one is usually inside to put inside the wall. because this one have a screw, so we can spin it freely to tighten it. And diameter is 6. As I mentioned before, the middle parts have to be very, very smooth. So the cylindrical is have to be in 0.06, make it move freely and more smooth. The next one is the lock. The lock is used to put with the arm, as I mentioned before, in the screw type hole. Because of it, you can screw it. So tighten the component with the machine so it not move get away when you drill it. There are also two parts. The top part is the one that you have to spin with your thumb or your hand. It's 15.3 diameter and 5 in thickness. Actually, this part has you can put some thumb grip or anything you want to make it handy when you use it. And the second part is screw surface. It's 10 in diameter and 25 in thickness. This one have to have the same surface as the part before, because you have to make it tightly and you have to spin it. You have to make the same surface diameter and everything. The final part is component. The component is the result of all the mechanic in the past machine do. When you put this in the middle of this machine, you can drill it in parallel hole. And as I show you in section view, in the this part is 30 millimeter in diameter and 25 in thickness, but you can customize whatever you want, not bigger than in this machine. The hole is 5 in diameter because of the bush I mentioned before. The bush in the part have 5 diameter in the center hole, so this part also have 5 also. You can put in the two parallel. And this we show you in not connect hole, so there are 4 of them. But you can do you can customize by yourself.
Step, we will describe business about this assembly and assembly method of this page. The first, I will represent about this assembly to remove the locking disc. Okay, the first we will remove the locking component and use the flathead screwdriver to tighten the arm. Pull it out and take out the arm piece. If so, then use the wrench to remove both 10 millimeter and 4 socket head cap screw on the bush wall and tighten, or which is M4 by 17 socket head cap screw on the bit, and the wall can be removed after that. Take the worst piece with the pin and bush attached with steel hammer and roller. We will take it into the anvil with a hammer and the roller, so the pin and the bush is completely removed and the component can be locked out. So, the next step we will explain about assembly.
In the part of the assembly, step 1, connect the wall to the base. Do not side 10 millimeter using the Allen wedge to assemble. Step 2, connect the component lock base with 2 M4 nuts length 14. Step 3, put the bush with bush wall by hammering and then bringing bush wall to blade with the M4 socket length 17. Step 4. Bring the arm holder and arm to the wall using a flathead screwdriver. Step 5. Bring the component lock to the arm. The last step is to put the part that you want to drill in the desired position. Thank you.
Okay. This machine have two standard parts variant. This one is the long one and another is short one. So let's begin with the short one. The short one is hexagon socket screw M4x10. ISO of this part is 4762. So when you take an order or buy in the part store, you can order in ISO 4762 hexagon socket screw M4x10, or just ISO 4762 and put the size and length. This part, the number of this part is 4, so it make tighten the base with the wall and push wall. So it's also one of the important parts. On the top, there are 6 hexagonal holes. You have put it with the tools. The second one is the long one. It have everything the same. ISO also 4762 hexagon socket screw M. Because this part is longer, so in the length. In the past, I mentioned M4x10 is the screw part, the screw surface part is 10 millimeter in length, but this part is longer, so and it's in 17. So when you order, you have to say ISO 4762 M4x17 screw. And this part is connect with base and base component lock. So it have to be tightened, very tightened, so it cannot loose and component cannot shake and get loose really easy. The next one is about assembly bowing.
Okay. The next we will talk about the bomb assembly. This workpiece we use, the material is steel, except standard part is socket 10 and socket 17. Who do you know about this?
The number item there and part number. So number one of there is push wall 1 to 12. As I mentioned before, some part cannot be seen by this picture because it in another side or it on the other side of this picture. So some cannot see. Every material you should mostly made from steel, except that part as she mentioned before. Quantity is different. For example, push wall, the base lock, the base. Basket pin, the lock, wall arm, and this have quantity of 2-1, and bush pin 15 and pin 13 have quantity of 2. As I mentioned, pin 15 and pin 13 is not the same because in diameter, so we make it easy to see. Socket 10 and socket 17 also the same thing. It's also the same ISO part, but we make it easy to understand. The socket 10 has quantity of 4. It's on the push wall side and underside in the other side of wall side. The socket 17 in the also in the underside in the to lock it with base and base component lock. and there's 12 of them, but 10 is part we have to make it, but and 2 is standard part. So standard part we don't have to do it because it, you can buy it in the market.
Okay, I think we would like to end the presentation. Thank you for watching. Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.